Happy evening, friends, and good wishes to my students. Today, I have just read a book, namely Vedanta, written by Swami Parthasarathi. After reading that book, I was tempted to look at their videos. After watching those videos, now I am tempted to share those teachings with you, especially to the students. Of course, it is useful to each and everybody. Today, I would like to discuss about three or four concepts given to us by them. The first one is, what is addiction? What is the definition of addiction according to Vedanta? What is self-management? What is mind? What is intellect? See, what is addiction? Today, we have heard that word addiction so many times. People are addicting to alcohol. People are addicting to drugs. People are losing peace of mind by addiction to particular bad habit. See, how to overcome this addiction? How to stop this addiction? That is one aspect. Then, what is intellect? Then another aspect. Then, what do we mean by the word mind? Then, what is the meaning of self-management? Let us see one by one. The first one, addiction. According to Vedanta, addiction means the mind craves, the intellect cannot control. Look at beautiful sentence. The mind craves, the intellect cannot control. What do you mean by that? Intelligence is different from intellect. I'll explain later. The mind craves. Mind desires. Minds want. What is a mind? Mind is a state of feelings, likes and dislikes, desires, emotions. So mind is a state of feeling. Mind cannot be seen by anybody. Mind is a thought process. Mind is bunch of thoughts. Mind is a state of feeling. Mind is a state of likes and dislikes. Mind is a place for emotion. Mind is a home or shelter for emotions. See, when mind likes it, when mind wants it, the intellect cannot control it. I'll explain with an example. Suppose a person is having diabetes mellitus, a metabolic disorder. Otherwise, a person has been suffering with diabetes from a long time, okay? His sugars are so high in the blood. So glucose level is so high in his blood. Doctors advised him not to take sweets. Before this metabolic disorder was found in him, he was fond of sweets very much. So what to do? So one day when he was moving around a sweet shop, he found sweets which were liked by him very much previously. His mind craves for those sweets. His mind wanted him to take those sweets. And he tells to himself, oh, doesn't matter if I take one or two sweets for one day, nothing will happen to me. So his mind craves, his mind likes to take those sweets, his mind wants to eat those sweets, but he ate it. So next day also, he had same thinking, he did the same thing, he repeated the same thing. Now his sugar levels rose up, got a problem. Then doctors advised him not to take sweets again. Okay, what happened here? Why he got that problem? Why his problem was elevated? Why his metabolic disorder was elevated? Why his sugar rose up, that caused another health problem? So his sugars rose up in the blood in such a way that there is a problem in kidney. So that led to the renal failure. So, but what, why it was happened? Because his intellect, the intellect means that is the capacity to reason, to judge, analyze, take decision and then action. That is intellect. The intellect is the capacity of a person to reason, to analyze, to judge, to take a decision and then come to the action. That is intellect. So he was weak intellect. He was not able to control his desire. So the intellect cannot control. That's why he took the sweets. So the ability of a person to reason, to analyze, to judge, take a decision and come to the action, that capacity we call it as intellect. If he could have been a better intellect, if he was so intellect, he could have stopped off taking sweets. So his mind dominated his intellect. He was poor in exhibiting his intellect capacity. That's why he was able to take the sweets. That caused the problem. That lost his peace of mind. That caused stress in him. So because of lacking intellect ability, made that person to undergo stress and to face other health problems. So my dear young children, the addiction is when the mind craves, then the intellect cannot control it. When the mind craves for a particular thing, when it is not advisable to take, that intellect cannot control it, then that is called as addiction. So a person being addicted to alcoholism, used to take so much of alcohol every day, that led to the problems in his liver, that led to the cirrhosis of his liver. Doctors asked him stop taking alcohol immediately, as it has already caused a problem in liver, causing the damage to the liver. So some cirrhosis conditions were there in the liver, but his mind craves for alcohol. You know, he has to reason, he has to analyze, he has to judge, he has to take a decision whether to take alcohol or not. So that capacity of analyzing, the capacity of judging, the capacity of reasoning, what happens if he takes, then capacity to take a decision and then come to the action is the intellect. When he strongly intellect, he immediately stops of taking alcohol. When he is weak in intellect, what happens? He takes alcohol, inviting death by damaging his liver totally. Look at this. That is called as addiction. When mind craves, the intellect cannot control it, we call it as addiction. When mind craves and then intellect cannot control it, we call it as addiction. When you develop intellect, when you develop ability to analyze, to reason, to judge, to take decision and come to the action, we call it as a better intellect. You should be a better intellect. When you are a better intellect, you will have a peace of mind. You will have a joyful life. You will have a pleasure in your life. Remember that. So that is addiction, and I have already explained intellect also. Getting information, knowledge, gathering information into your brain is nothing but intelligence. You may be the best intelligent, you may be having the best intelligency, doesn't matter. But unless and until how to utilize that intelligency, how to analyze the knowledge you have, or how to analyze, take a decision what your mind wants, you will be in trouble. So that's why, now self-management. What do you mean by self-management? So that we'll discuss on another day, because I'll have to attend another lecture to students. And thank you for listening, for watching this. So I'm so impressed after reading their books and watching their videos. And so now you have come to know what is addiction and what is intellect, what is intelligency, what is mind. Practice this in your life, especially to my students. You will be the happiest students and you will achieve what you want in your life when you develop better intellect. So, right? Shubham Bhuyat. Namaskar.